Now, before you go diving into the gorgeous blue waters of Barbados, there are definitely a few things you need to know before you go. That's why in this video, we're going to share with you all of the important things you need to know, including currency concerns, where to stay, the best time of year to visit, how to get around the island, and just how safe Barbados is. Knowing these tips will make planning your trip so much easier, so you can arrive prepared and ready to hit the ground running. Now, I'm Kendra Lucas.
And I'm David Lucas of Lucas World Travel. And we spent a month in Barbados as a workcation, doing a little bit of work and exploring a lot of the island. Now, we spent a total of 6 months in the Caribbean, so be sure to subscribe to see even more beautiful islands and all of our best tips for enjoying them. But for now, let's dive into the 15 things you need to know before you go to Barbados. First, let's talk about the money in Barbados. So the currency in Barbados is Barbadian dollar, which is at the rate of one Barbadian dollar to 50 cents USD. When you arrive, you can easily get Barbadian dollars out of the ATM to use. You can also bring US dollars because you can use both Barbadian dollars and US dollars interchangeably in the island. So if you're coming from the US, you don't have to change any money at all. However, when you get change, you will probably get Barbadian dollars in return. Credit cards are widely accepted around the island, but naturally, you need cash for smaller food vendors and street vendors. Tipping is also common at full-service restaurants and with your taxi drivers at a rate of about 10 to 15%. You might even see a service charge automatically added to your bill at more upscale restaurants. So be on the lookout before you pay your bill.
Next up, let's talk about the best place to stay on the island. Now, the best side of the island to stay on is the southwest side, and that's going from Carlisle Bay all the way to Oystens. So just look at all of my Google map pins here. Nearly all the beautiful beaches, delicious restaurants, and fun nightlife spots are on this part of the island. So if you book your hotel along this coast, you can't go wrong. Plus, the amount of ZR minivans available on this side of the island is unreal. We never had to wait more than 1 to 2 minutes for a minivan, so getting around using public transport is a breeze. You also have two nightlife options on this side of the island. You can go to Oystens every Friday night for the fish fry, and you have St. Lawrence Gap, which you can go practically any other night of the week. Although minivans are the best way to get around the south side of the island, outside of that, you probably should rent a car because navigating the rest of the island through public transportation can be a bit of a challenge.
And that brings us to our next item, getting around the island. Public transportation is an excellent option to get anywhere along the coast. Minivans are privately owned and very convenient because they make change for you. The fare is 350 Barbados dollars. Although minivans will make change for you, the larger city buses do not. You are supposed to have exact change when you ride the city bus. Another way to get around Barbados is by taxi. They do not use Uber there. Instead, they have their own app called Pickup Barbados Taxi App. We used it once and it got us to the airport successfully. A 9 kilometer or 5 mile ride will cost you around 24 to 28 USD.
Now, outside of using the minivans, you'll either need to rent a car or to book a tour to see the rest of the island. Now, if you feel comfortable driving on the left side of the road, then I do highly recommend renting a car. We paid about $43 a day for a rental with Tweety Rental and had a very good experience with them. However, since then, I've seen much cheaper rental rates on Discover Cars, so I've included a link to them in the description box below, so hopefully you can check them out and get an even better rate than that. However, you have to keep in mind that we were in Barbados during high season, So a lot of the places I called didn't have any more cars available. They were sold out. So we were paying higher prices because there was less selection. If you go off season, however, you can get some really cheap rental car rates. However, if you don't want to drive yourself, I'll include some island tour options in the description box as well, because I do have some words of caution for you about driving in Barbados. Now, first of all, they drive on the left side of the road, which can be a real challenge for us North Americans. The biggest challenge, though, is navigating the narrow roads and avoiding destroying your tires and all of the thousands of potholes that exist around the island. And let me just tell you, the sound your car makes when it falls into a pothole is so dramatically loud that you will be convinced that you just popped your tire at least 2 to 3 times a day. Our car rental company even warned us. She was like, it's very common to get a flat in Barbados because of the severity of the pothole issue. And you will be responsible to fix any flats or to replace any destroyed tires. So I would not say that driving in Barbados is particularly easy, but we were able to manage without any major issues. So I would still recommend it as a great way to see the beautiful nature of the north side of the island, the east, and the central side of the island as well. Even though the potholes were a real hassle, I still think the freedom you gain having your own vehicle is worth it.
The best time to visit Barbados is December to April, because that is considered the dry season. We were there in March, and I can happily report that the weather was amazing during that time. There was the occasional rain system that passed through, but those storms were short and quickly passed by, leaving beautiful blue skies. Rainy season and hurricane season is from June to November. This is when it rains most often, and there's also a chance of big hurricanes coming through. Most recently, Hurricane Beryl passed by in late June, causing some damage. They get hurricanes like this every 2 to 5 years, so hopefully they won't get another one for a while. But naturally, a hurricane is not something you can predict. So again, the best time and the most popular time will be December to April, with May being a good shoulder season month to explore the island.
The next thing you need to know is the language, and English is the primary language in Barbados. However, you'll also hear some Bajan Creole on the island as well. I'm not gonna lie though, even though the primary language is English, I had some trouble understanding people's accents. So just so you know, when you speak English, everyone will understand you just fine. But whether or not you will understand their accent is a different story. But this really didn't cause us any major issues or difficulties. There were only a few moments where we were just like, huh? But luckily, we understood the person after the second or maybe third try.
Another thing that's unique in Barbados is it's illegal to wear camouflage clothing in Barbados. Camouflage clothing is reserved for military personnel only, so you can't wear camouflage print of any sort. And it doesn't matter if your camo print is green, pink, blue, or if it's on your backpack or on your water bottle. It's all illegal. So be sure to leave that stuff at home.
Another important thing to know about Barbados is what local foods to try. In general, you want to try the fish. We particularly like the flying fish and the little fish balls that you get. So delicious. I also really love the macaroni pie. It was by far, I think, our favorite side dish while we were on the island, and we ordered it with practically everything. I also recommend trying the local fast food restaurant, Chefette, because their fried chicken and their burgers are so good. And even though it's fast food, it is still special because it's a uniquely Bajan fast food restaurant. You can only get that stuff there.
Another thing to know is that groceries are surprisingly expensive in Barbados. So you should know that the cheapest grocery store on the island is called Popular. We shopped there while we had a rental car. It was a bit too far away otherwise. The Massey grocery stores were shockingly expensive. And don't worry, we'll do a whole other video talking about how expensive Barbados is. So be sure to subscribe for that one.
One good thing though is that you can drink the tap water in Barbados. So you can at least save some money by not buying bottled water while you're on the island. So be sure to bring your reusable water bottle with you when you come to Barbados.
You'll also want to bring a lot of sun protection, including sunblock, hats, sunglasses. We also brought our snorkel and fins as well, so we could swim out to the shipwreck at Carlisle Bay and go snorkeling at Folkestone Marine Park. However, most other beaches don't have much to see in the water snorkeling-wise, so you will only need the fins at Folkestone Marine Park and Carlisle Bay. There will be occasional sea turtles passing through at most beaches, though, so it's good to have your snorkels and mask handy. So when you see the sea turtles from the shore, you can swim out and swim with them. We personally were not able to scout the turtles while in the water. We found them easier to see from the shore and then swim out to meet them.
Now the next big question we always get is how safe is it? So let's share the stats with you. Now first of all, the U.S. State Department rates Barbados as a level one country, which is the lowest and safest level you can be at. So you can just use ordinary safety precautions and you'll be perfectly fine in Barbados. Now, while we were there, there were a few streets that we drove down that looked a little rough. And this was mostly because the streets had quite a few prostitutes hanging around outside. So we're like, where are we? We didn't know at the time that Barbados has a red light district. And so we were surprised to see it, not knowing that it was there. Although we were surprised to see the red light district, it doesn't mean that area is unsafe or anything like that. Barbados crime statistics are actually very low. So for a population of 280,000 people, last year they only had 16 murders, 58 robberies, and 22 rapes. Now, in my opinion, those stats are quite low. However, I always like to compare, is this destination safer than where I'm from? And I'm happy to report that Barbados is definitely much safer than my home state of Tennessee in the U.S. So I'll compare the crime stats for Knoxville, Tennessee, which has a bit smaller population than Barbados at 195,000 people. Yet, it still has a higher crime rate with 32 murders, 182 robberies, and 155 rapes. And compare that to where I'm actually from in Nashville with a population of 690,000, and you can see just how low Barbados crime stats are, even when adjusting for population size. Now, naturally, you will need to look up your own city's crime stats to know whether or not Barbados is safer than where you're from. But for us, it's a resounding yes, it's much safer than where we're from.
The next thing you should know about are the outlets. Barbados use type A and type B outlets, which are used throughout the Americas. So if you're coming from the US or Canada, you will not need any adapters. If you're coming from the UK and Europe, you will definitely need the two flat pin adapter.
Lastly, up to 72 hours in advance of your arrival, you can fill out your digital immigration card. So you will have all your documents ready when you get to passport control. I've included a link to the digital immigration form in the description box below. So be sure to check that out along with all the other resources. So we hope these tips can make your time in Barbados a great one. And if you think we left anything off, please help your fellow travelers out and leave your essential Barbados travel tips in the comment section below. Up next, we'll be posting our cost of living in Barbados video. So be sure to like, subscribe, and ring the bell to get even more useful travel tips from the Caribbean and from all around the world. Until then, you can watch all of our current Barbados guides on the right there. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see where in the world we are currently. As always, world travelers, thanks so much for watching. Thanks for sharing with all your travel pals, and happy travel planning. Until next time.